So we're there.
Yeah, I know, right?
That was nice.
This is weird. We've changed the format up for this show.
Yes, and we lost a guy.
We did lose a guy. We may actually change the title next week.
Probably
so we're gonna maybe just call it Guys Talk Knives instead of three.
Guys Talk Knives work.
I mean, if he hadn't smarted off, we wouldn't have to take him down. So.
Well, it was a knife that got rid of him.
It is what it is.
He got cut.
In case you're wondering, we are going to video this. It's going to be in a podcast, and we're going to do things a little bit differently than we have in our past episodes.
So, a little more conversational.
Yeah, probably. So, I mean, I guess that's what it'd be. But today's show, what's in your pocket? Be careful. be careful what you pull out of your pocket.
Yeah. Don't answer this question if you're at work, unless you're us.
Right. Of course.
Because it works. Yeah,
no.
So, on the count of three.
Okay. One. Two, three.
Oh, yours is much more expensive than mine.
Wait. What are the odds that we both have Chinese knives?
I was about to say something to that effect because it, and on complete different ends of the spectrum.
Absolutely. Like yours is how much?
$12.99. Yes, sir.
So we could get like 50 of yours for.
Oh, at least because yours was.
$375. So what do you got? Show me what you got.
Okay, this is the... I'm actually going to cheat this to the camera.
Oh, that's fine.
Because for the video viewers at home, you'll be able to see it that way. This is the new Rough Rider hatchet. This is brand new, literally just in the catalog. G10 handle, 440A, stainless steel blade. Anodized, it's blued on the blade. Anodized blue hardware on the clip and on the thumb studs. Sorry, I forgot. No. It's assisted opening... which is kind of groovy, and for a $12.99 knife, I don't know that you can beat that, but I dig it because I like the styling. I wanted to get the Gerber cleaver of the same style.
Yeah, the flat iron, the new Gerber flat iron.
And I was like, oh, I want to play with this instead because I'm a sucker for Rough Rider anyway. And
it's assisted really, opening well as well,
it
right?
It is, yeah.
So,
and I dig it.
Got the liner lock.
Yep.
That's pretty nice.
Sits well in your pocket.
That
you just really... Again, for $12.99?
Right. No, I'm with you.
I've had it for about a week now, and I've used it numerous times.
That's an eighth-inch thick. It's
a thick blade. Trust me, and I have... You could probably open a paint can with that. And
that's
if
nice.
You broke it, it's $12.99.
Right.
You can replace it.
Right. So this is Rough Rider.
It's Rough Rider.
This is, you know, most people think of Rough Rider, think of traditional knives, traditional pocket knives.
They do, and this is kind of a new line they're doing where they're getting a little bit more tactical.
Right.
Their Giant Man Stiletto, which is like a two-hand folding machete.
I always like to hold it with two hands.
You would have to. It's just gigantic knife. This thing is part of that same line and feel from Rough Rider, and I dig it.
Nice lanyard hole.
Yeah.
It is just a one-position clip. That's not bad, though.
Yeah. Again, you're not going for lots of versatility in this. But it's...
You know, the dangerous thumb stud, as I always...
I don't... You know me. I don't use a thumb stud. I like to pop a knife open upside down.
Yeah, you like to do that little number right there.
Yeah. Every time.
You know, I like it. I dig it. Yeah. $12.99, you can't beat it.
You really can't. And again, it's something new that I said, I need one of those. So I bought it at the showroom.
Yeah. So, I mean...
But let's move on to this
work of
first
art.
First thing, first things first. Look how much bigger that knife is.
Let's do this so they can see on the video.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, you're talking about 8.5 inches overall, right?
Big knife.
You're talking about over 4 inches on the handle and 3.5 inch. We're a little cheated, 3.6.
Now what, this is a re-8.
It is, it's a re-8. It's a high-end Chinese knife.
Look at the
around
detailing.
So they can see the front of that and we'll talk it through. This is M390 Bowler Steel on the blade.
Wow.
It is actually two-tone, which is kind of killer.
It really is.
It is, on part of the grind, it's a satin finish. On the other part, it's stonewashed, which you can see here in extra part of that. It has ambidextrous thumb studs. It's got the flipper. And the handle is all titanium. It is titanium from start to finish. Now, most people put in anodized aluminum for hardware and that kind of stuff. No, this is titanium hardware that's been anodized blue.
So that's why it's so light.
Yes.
This is a big chunk of a knife.
Right.
But it doesn't... It's not heavy.
No. And what's impressive on it more than anything is that flipper actions. It's ceramic ball bearings. It is unbelievable.
It is as fast as it can be. That's impressive.
Right. It just... You can hold it any way you want, and it just I'll try it out. I mean, yeah. It's crazy town how easy that is to use one-handed, how easy it is to close down without killing yourself.
What's
with
amazing
it.
Is the details. Again, you look at the time on the blue in right. different places to make it pop a little bit, even on the spine back here.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I mean, you've got a titanium spacer with anodized wow. titanium enhancements down the back of it.
I love it.
The thing that is crazy about this knife, I mean, that is a 3D machine. It is a milled titanium yeah. pocket clip.
Sure.
A milled titanium pocket clip. Sure, it only goes in one spot, but it's milled titanium, so it doesn't need to go in more than one spot.
But I'm not the person to talk to about the movable pocket clips, because to me, just buy a different knife.
Screw you, Lefty. Get another pocket knife.
No, I'm not saying that, but there are other options out there.
Right.
So if you don't like this one, I guarantee Re8 has something, probably on the same money, that has a reversible.
Yeah.
Or has a different carry style.
Yeah, if you don't know anything about Re8 isn't an incredible brand. So they have, not low end, but they've got mid-range, and they've got all the way to what we're looking at here is at 375. But, I mean,
375.
I'm serious, right?
Wow.
And so the thing in my mind is that,
And knowing you didn't sharpen this?
No, I didn't. That's out of the box.
Straight out of the box.
Yeah, no, because I don't sharpen. I dull knives.
This
do it myself.
Is not sharp out of the box.
Right.
But it would take a really
this
good
is edge. Insane. Let's go camera three. Let's go with this, John. I mean, look. I mean, that's out of the box.
Yeah.
I mean,
and every Re8 I've ever handled.
I bet he loves that in the sound, too.
It has to be nice.
It has to be great.
Right in his ears.
And if you're listening to this on the podcast, we're actually just sitting here making noises with our mouths. No, yes. We're actually cutting.
We have a Foley guy back in the back. That's all he does.
he
sits around and cuts paper all day long.
So, no. I mean, I'm trimming up my notes here, but, I mean, that's like a pair of scissors.
It really is.
I mean, it's pretty amazing. Look, I made a shield.
Now, the other Rough Rider I bought the same day.
You know, we've already been going for 8 minutes. Can you believe that? That's crazy, right?
I completely believe that, yeah. But it's me and you, and that isn't surprising.
No, because, we do this at lunch, and 3 hours later, we get in trouble. So
was just that sharp out of the box.
Oh, wow.
I bought the new cotton sampler.
How is this one on thing? Let's go camera three again. Let's just see. Jason's used it for a while.
It might actually beat it.
Whoa.
Well, you know it's sharp.
That's not bad.
But
you can see it starts to catch an edge.
See? It's more of a bludgeoning tool.
just beat them with your hatchet.
You can, yeah.
You could just beat them with your hatchet. The thing is with these Chinese knives, I mean, people think that, I don't know what they think. So you say American made, right?
Sure.
It becomes this thing, I want American made. But if I showed you a Swiss Army knife, you would go.
It's not American made.
No, it's
Boker.
It's made in Switzerland.
Sure. And is one of the most used, most recognized knives in
right.
the world.
Every time Essie comes in the house, you ask them what the other knife in their pocket is, it's probably a Victorinox.
Almost every time.
Almost every time.
Almost every time.
You talk about Opinel, which has been around for centuries. French.
It's French.
Right. But
Boker.
You say Chinese, and I mean, people automatically think that.
Inferior.
Junk. Yeah, inferior. It's
I wouldn't go so far as junk, but the thought is, and I hate to put it this way, the thought is this. The thought is
right.
inexpensive.
But Rough Rider is a well-made knife.
But this is a quality knife.
Yeah.
It's a G10 handle. Right. It is 440 stainless steel. Now, are you going to take this into the woods and live off of it as a bushcraft knife?
No.
No, you're not.
Because I don't do that.
You don't go outside.
But not
but
a lot.
This isn't designed to be a bushcraft knife. This is designed to open letters and packages.
And look cool and be fun.
And look cool. That is a high-end Chinese knife.
Mm-hmm. And the quality, I mean, I said this to you before we started today because I thought it was important. You could literally, if you scrubbed off that Re8 right there and scrubbed off what's on the back,
if I
tagged that with ZT, you would go, man, that's a killer ZT.
Yeah. Because the styling is very simple.
The styling, the action,
the quality,
it's all there.
The materials.
It is, right?
Yeah.
But again, the price point is where it should be for a titanium, all titanium knife.
Exactly.
M390. And, I mean, whoa.
Not anymore.
Not anymore. Just broke the tip off. No, but it's actually, I think a lot of times we put this thing in our head where we say something is junk. We've heard it all our lives. I think that if more people held it in their hand and just tried out a Chinese knife, they might. And I'm not here to sell Chinese knives.
No, not at all.
Right?
I'm just saying. True story from the showroom.
Okay.
I am walking around one day. I'm at the case counter. I was getting something to shoot for the web.
Mm-hmm.
And this gentleman had just bought one of the new pumpkin patterns, the old school logo on the orange handles.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
The pumpkin pattern knife. And it's a beautiful knife. He had just bought one. He said, the problem is I don't want to take an $80 knife into the barn with me.
Right.
He collects case.
Right.
But I don't want to destroy it.
Right.
And I said, you need to buy a Rough Rider to take to the barn. He bought six.
Right.
Stockmans.
Right.
Yellow handle, Rough Rider Stockmans, and said, I'm going to leave three at the barn and three at the house.
Right. Because you can. You can.
It's a working knife. Again,
and here's
not,
the thing.
He's not going to use it to help birth a cow.
Right.
But for cutting twine.
Right.
Works great. Good knife.
And the fit and finish is great.
Sure it is.
I mean, and a lot of it has to do with what you demand out of the China factories. And
exactly.
We, for years with Rough Rider, have demanded that quality.
Sure.
And it comes back to that quality. It's all about quality assurance and quality control. And if you look at the fit and finish on a Rough Rider traditional knife,
of course,
it's amazing.
And they look really, really good. And again, you're not going to break the bank.
Right.
And you're going to have a good quality knife, especially one that you want to use.
Right. I'm going to die of choking to death here. You choked me to death, Jason.
I tried.
Hey, it happens.
And then, you know, you can also spend the money, though, on a good quality, well-produced, good materials, great materials, Chinese knife.
And you can find in between this. What is the other? Kaiser.
Oh, sure.
Kaiser. So you're talking about in between this and other Chinese brand, high quality,
I'll even
mid-range price.
Down from there.
What's that?
Those Rike knives.
Yes.
R-U-I-K-E.
Yes.
It's owned by Phoenix.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah.
And the price point's between $40 and $60.
Yeah, same as Kaiser. Kaiser is right in that same range, $50 to $70.
Sure.
As sometimes even as low as $35. It's just amazing.
Sometimes on flash sales,
but
even cheaper than that.
But if you come into the showroom and pick up these, just hold them.
Go handle
one. Just play with it. I mean, it's just is what it is. You need to feel it. It's easy to dismiss something when you don't know what it is.
Sure.
It really is. And I'm sure I'm guilty of it more than anybody else. I just miss it out of hand.
Does it have the history of a case knife?
No, and it's not going to.
It's not intended to.
No, exactly.
It's not intended
Absolutely.
To.
Absolutely. So I keep getting, you know, hand signals from John that we're actually
and
up
some of them are not very nice.
No, they're not. He just,
they're rude.
He actually, he's screaming with his hands like,
beating the glass. You can't hear it. We had it muted.
Because we're up to actually like 12 minutes now.
Probably so.
Just, that's about what it is. So let's go and wrap it up. If you want to find out about these knives at all, if you want to do that, I just totally screwed John on that shot. Put yours right in here. Put it right in here. So what I'm going to do is, if you're watching this video online, I'm going to throw the links in the description below.
Definitely.
I have no idea until Jason tells me how a podcast works, where the links will be. It'll be
podded.
And casted. And casted in both. We'll put the links to both of these, as well as the category links for Rough Rider and for Re-8.
For Re-8.
We might even throw Kaiser in there as well. Just as,
might
just
as well. We've talked about it. We'll probably do a whole page to kind of to beef out the notes on the show notes.
Right, right.
On the podcast page.
But so, you know, that's what's in our pockets today.
For sure.
And that'll do it for Guys time. Talk Knives, yeah.
Definitely.
For sure. Smoky Mountain Knife Works. If it cuts, we carry it.